Welcome students for this session. Today in this session, let's continue to learn the lesson, The Portrait of a Lady. In previous session, we learned about the author's relationship with his grandmother. They lived together in the village. They enjoyed intimate relationship and were good friends. Our author's parents left him with her and they went to live in the city. They were constantly together. Who were? Our author and his grandmother were constantly together. She used to wake him up in the morning and get him ready for school. She used to accompany him to the school. She carried several chapatis for the village dogs. She used to stay in the temple that was attached to school. After school hours, they would walk together. This much we learned in the previous session. Now let's continue to learn. My parents were comfortably settled in the city. They sent for us. That was a turning point in our friendship. Although we shared the same room, my grandmother no longer came to school with me. I used to go to an English school in a motor bus. There were no dogs in the streets and she took to feeding sparrows in the courtyard of our city house. Yes, as I said in the beginning, the parents settled in the city and called our Arthur and his grandmother to the city. So they were going there. They settled and he joined in a English school and he used to go by motor bus. So his mother was not accompanying him. His grandmother was not accompanying him. And there were also no dogs. In village there were many dogs. They used to give chapati for the dogs. No, here there were no dogs. Only there were sparrows. So his grandmother used to feed the sparrows. As the years rolled by, we saw less of each other. For sometimes she continued to wake me up and get me ready for school. When I came back, she would ask me what the teacher had taught me. I would tell her English words and little things of Western science and learning. The law of gravity, Archimedes' principle, the world being round, etc. This made her unhappy. She could not help me with my lessons. She did not believe in the things they taught at the English school and was distressed that there was no teaching about God and the scriptures. She said nothing, but her silence meant disapproval. She rarely talked to me after that. Yes, beginning in first session we told that they related with each other as friends. In fifth point, it is told that though they share in same room, but she was not accompanying him to the school. In sixth point, it is told that they used to see each other hardly. So for some days she used to wake him up in the morning, and after school also she used to ask him, what did you learn in your school? He used to tell what he learned, but she was not happy with that because she was feeling that school they are not teaching about God. For that she was unhappy. And as the days were going, she stopped asking him what he learned in that school. When I went up to university, I was given a room of my own. The common link of friendship was snapped. My grandmother accepted her seclusion with resignation. She rarely left her spinning wheel to talk to anyone. From sunrise to sunset, she sat by her wheel spinning and reciting prayers. Only in the afternoon, she relaxed for a while to feed the sparrows. While she sat in the veranda, breaking the bread into little bits, hundreds of little birds collected round her, creating a veritable bedlam of chirpings. Some came and perched on her legs, but she never shooed them away. It used to be the happiest of hour of the day for her. Okay, Hjort said that he went to university to do his higher studies, and he was given a separate room. Here, whereas grandmother was sitting alone in wheelchair, she used to always recite prayers, rosaries. Okay, only that afternoon alone, she spent half an hour to feed the sparrow birds. Next, when I decided to go abroad for further studies, I was sure my grandmother would be upset. I would be away for 5 years, and at her age, one could never tell. But my grandmother could. She was not even sentimental. She came to leave me at the railway station, but did not talk or show any emotion. Her lips moved in prayer. Her mind was lost in prayer. Her fingers were busy telling the beads of her rosary. Silently, she kissed my forehead, and when I left, I cherished the moist imprint as perhaps the last sign of physical contact between us. Yes. He decided to go abroad for his further studies. So he was thinking, if I tell my grandmother, she will be feeling very bad that I am going to leave her for 5 years. But what happened? She didn't show any of that emotions. Okay. When she wants to give send off for him, she just went with him to the railway station. She didn't show any of the emotions, and just she was reciting the prayers. But that was not so. After 5 years, I came back home and was met by her at the station. She did not look a day older. She still had no time for words, and while she clasped me in her arms, I could hear her reciting her prayers. Even on the first day of my arrival, her happiest moments were with her sparrows, whom she fed longer and with frivolous rebukes. Okay, here, 5 years over, he has completed, and he was coming again. Then also she was coming there to railway station to pick him up. There also she was reciting the prayers. Okay. Before 5 years, when he was going also, she was reciting the prayers. And now when he returned back also, she was going on reciting the prayers. And on the first day also, she didn't give much time for him. And she continuously start to give half an hour for the sparrows and the birds. She was feeding the sparrows. A change came over her. She did not pray. She collected the women of the neighborhood, got an old drum, and started to sing. Okay. We have learned that she was always reciting her prayers in rosary. But that particular day, she didn't tell the prayers. Instead, she gathered all the neighbors and she enjoyed. That means she was singing with them. For several hours, she thumped the sagging skins of the dilapidated drum and sang of the homecoming of the warrior. We had to persuade her to stop to avoid overstraining. That was the first time since I had known her that she did not pray. That means, that day she was not praying. She gathered all the neighbors and she was enjoying by singing. These people, he and his mother, father and da, they were asking her to not to strain more. And our poet, our author also is telling, this is the first day I am seeing her without praying. Next. The next morning she was taken ill. It was a mild fever and the doctor told us that it would go. But my grandmother thought differently. Yes. Next morning she got a fever. Doctor told, okay, after some days it will be she will be cured. But my grandmother thought differently. She told us that her end was near. She said that since only a few hours before the close of the last chapter of her life, she had omitted to pray, she was not going to waste any more time talking to us. she was telling, I'm going to die, my end is very near. And she was telling, she that last day, no, she didn't pray, she was feeling for that, and she told that she was thinking that hereafter I'm not going to waste a minute. We protested, but she ignored our protest. She lay peacefully in bed praying and telling her beads. Even before we could suspect, her lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. A peaceful pallor spread on her face and we knew that she was dead. Yes? Okay, they were telling, no, you will not die, all those things they were telling. But she told that, I am not going to waste a single minute. I am going to pray. And she started to pray. And after some moments, her lips stopped. That means she died. The sun was setting and had lit her room and veranda with a blaze of golden light. We stopped halfway in the courtyard, all over the veranda and in her room, right up to where she lay dead, and still wrapped in the red shroud. Thousands of sparrows sat scattered on the floor. There was no chirping. We felt sorry for the birds, and my mother fetched some bread for them. She broke it into little crumbs the way my grandmother used to and threw it at them. The sparrows took no notice of the bread. When we carried my grandmother's corpse off, they flew away quietly. Next morning, the sweepers swept the bread crumbs into the dustbin. Yes, his grandmother died and they were keeping her body in veranda. All the sparrows were sitting in that veranda, okay, spread all around the veranda, and they were sitting. So his mother, what she was thinking, they are hungry. Usually grandmother used to feed, no? So in the same way, our Arthur's mother also was taking some bread and she broke into pieces and she was throwing it to them, but they did not eat, just they were sitting there. When they carried the grandmother's body, the sparrows just flew away. Okay. Next month, they didn't even eat the bread. Next morning, the sweepers swept it.